the ruffians, the wastrels, common thieves and thugs and all sorts of people are brought out and punished at the American Cross. Now that structure you saw there behind you dates from 1885, so that's a Victorian version of the American Cross. But there has been a American Cross in the area since the 14th century. And although that's a stone structure, previous American Crosses were made of wood. And in fact, there's an older version of the American Cross. Parts of it were taken away and used inside that one. So there's still remnants of a more historical American Cross in the higher classes of Edinburgh. It's back in the 1780s. The Industrial Revolution is taking hold. There's more wealth in the city. People are leaving the poverty of the Royal Mile and building fancy Georgian mansions in what they call Edinburgh Newtown, just north of Princess Street in the centre of Edinburgh. So to be working in the building trade, working in building furniture, was a fantastic time, fantastic opportunity to make lots and lots of cash. Deacon Brodie's workshop here was doing constant business. And he Covenanters fought for the Scottish Presbyterian religion, covenant with God. Covenanters, and named after the national.